to them. But I'm trying to keep things a bit different so they're not identical. It's time for another Death Road to Canada run, and we are going this time with the Shimada brothers. And I'm going to be Genji, and his buddy, his frenemy, is going to be Hanzo. Let's get started! Genji hears rumors that Canada is a safe place free of the threat of zombies. With nothing to gain from waiting around in Florida, he braves the Death Road to Canada with his Tissandere brother. Hit the road! Thank you for the host, Dragonicus. I'll make everyone else at some point, don't worry. To start the journey, the group decides to grab... This seems new as well, that it's patched in, you always get this choice very early on. What was kind of screwing us over last time? Probably a lack of food, so we shall go to the Yawl Mart. The group spots an abandoned Yawl Mart off in the distance. It looks like it's been looted, but maybe there's still some untouched loot inside. Go bargain hunting! Oh, Genji started with literally nothing, and Hanzo started with a crowbar. Okay. Let's do it. So I'm just going to cry chop all the zombies, although apparently he's pretty good at it. It's pretty fast too, his fitness stat must be through the roof. We've got to get a rifle for Hanzo at some point. One lonely, disturbing looking zombie in the bathroom? That's weird. Why do all these zombies have love hearts in their back? Rusty machete, although to be honest, my kung fu seems to be doing pretty well so far. Oh, toilet gas. I have not reached Canada in any run yet, I've not even come close. Although to be fair, I am using silly builds, I'm not like trying to find the most ideal mix of perks. I'm just trying to make my friends and Overwatch characters. Ooh. I like the sledgehammer. I would also like this fuel. I am still going to use Kung Fu though. I did start a new run while we were gone. Yes, the other run rended? I'm not Scooby-Doo. Ended with someone being eaten. Did I miss a door? Oh, even if I did, I think we've got a pretty good haul to probably call that quits. Great job! Kung Fu! The Kung Fu is really effective! High noon. Oh, I'd have to make a pistol guy to be McCree, yeah. Well, luckily Deus Ex has a McCree. That went well. The group goes against their judgment and camps in a city apartment because there's no zombies around. When they wake up, the building is on fire! Who will lead the escape? Well, Hanzo's composure is awful, so he definitely will not. We'll have to find out what Genji's is. Also, Genji misses hot water heaters, most of all. Hanzo feels like luck will soon be on his side. Gotta try Genji. Damn it. He panics, and this wastes precious time. Alright, well now he's a cyborg ninja anyway, because he got set on fire again. But they are also wounded. Unfortunate. The group reaches the city as it starts to rain. The drizzle seems to rile up the local zombies, so they are irritated. Pet shop or a bar? Pet shop for medicine. We're gonna have to go as is. Yep. Well, actually, I can give him the knife, because I'm using Kung Fu mostly, anyway. Call mercy? I wouldn't mind. Alright. Kung Fu. Pet stuff first. Nothing but bones. Is there actually nothing here? Oh, there's a dog. There's actually a lot of dogs. The dog is feral and is no longer capable of trusting humans. This dog's eyes glimmer with recognition for a brief moment. Aww. What about you? Same. Alright. So I guess this is where there's a chance to recruit a dog, but not always. I anticipated them attacking me when I picked that up. Damn, you could have gotten drunk. Sake! Just lure them around here. Let's actually try and get something for our trouble here. Some food, that helps. Close the doors. I don't like how many zombies are filtering in. Kung Fu them all! Destroy them! Parry their attacks! Ooh. Sake! Yep. Sorry, we're not getting Hanzo drunk. Not this time, anyway. Nope. Well, there's gotta be more of use here. Pistol ammo? Shotgun ammo? Nothing in there except a zombie. You look like a turtle. Ooh, alright, here we have... Oh, didn't realize there was one crab in there. Here we have actually some stuff. Hanzo, I need you to pick up basically everything you can here. Hang on, what do I have that I can get rid of? The bone. I don't need the bone. But the stuff Hanzo's got is probably fine. So if I get rid of that and pick up the spatula. There we are. Alright. Oh, but now I don't have a kung fu slot. This patch a little break soon. Alright, time to leave. Oh wait, missed something back here apparently. Oh, it was just that I hadn't been here, I think. How'd you get those emotes? You have to subscribe to my Twitch channel. That's not the same as subscribing on YouTube. Subscribing to a Twitch channel costs money. It's a monthly recurring thing, but you get my face next to your name when you're chatting in here, and you get the emotes to use on any Twitch channel you're watching. Did I go in here? I did. Alright, we'll call it quits there. Let's go. Following a channel on Twitch is free. It just means you can get an email sent to you when the channel goes live. Also, we are getting a little bit of a red bitrate there. Yep, we started to drop a few frames. Is that me or is that Twitch? Oh. I'll wait on the screen for a second. We're still losing frames here? It seems to be okay now. We're back in the green. There was a little bit of frame drop there. Dropped 1,000 frames. Alright, it seems to be okay. The way ahead, there's a big tree. Yeah, it looks like someone could cut it down or block the road. It would take a group of strong people to move it. Take a detour. The group decides to take a detour. This is usually a bad idea. We lost 61 gas! Genji rolls up his sleeves and starts tending to their wounds. Genji is really terrible at this. Medical revealed bad. That's why he hurt so much when he got set on fire. I still have 88 fuel left, but still. The group couldn't find any safe shelters, but was able to cobble together a campsite. The weather is terrible all night. Genji's morale decreases. Hanzo thought the weather was nice. His morale increased. His wits are revealed as bad. His attitude is amazing. Alright, Genji's morale went back up because they ate a good meal. Alright. Yeah, it was dropping a few frames. It seems fine though. The group gets a peaceful moment to rest in a safe house. No zombies in sight. With some spare time, they decide to cool it. Hanzo teach mechanical skills or Hanzo teach medical skills? I have a feeling I know which option you're going to want me to pick, and I'm not sure what it's going to do because we don't have anybody with the cool it option here, I thought. Do we have a consensus here? Also, what is that Twitch emote that's just a can of Twitch cola or something? It's weird. Alright, we have one vote for Cool It. Medical. Still being lad, I like that you're thinking with your head here. Another for medical, another for medical. I've seen enough medicals that I'm doing the smart option. Medical. Hanzo teaches Genji what he knows about emergency medical care and semi-painless dentistry, but not how to cure a person who's been set on fire. He doesn't know much about it. It's a completely useless lesson. Oh. Well, on the plus side, he got happier. He didn't teach him anything, though. Damn it. Am I going to BlizzCon? Absolutely not. It's in America, isn't it? Around the other side of the world. There's an upright dog here. Group finds a dog surrounded by a bunch of ammo. The dog speaks. Welcome to Ammo Emporium. Everything must go. No. I love that you're an upright dog, but we are not needing ammo. Hello. Hey, get out of my house. Alright, I'm just taking your medicine first, though. That's the lady with the chainsaw that if you tell her to cool it, she kills you. You want fuel. Oh, you're selling fuel, right? Yeah, he stinks of gasoline. Oh yeah, I think that's the guy we tried to rob his soul food, right? And he panicked and dropped the Molotov. You don't want to be doing that. Oh no, now everybody's discovered the Twitch canimal. Oh yeah, I like the face from Deus Ex 1 though. What is that? DXA Bomb. Yeah, that's the guy you played as in Deus Ex 1. A particularly intense looking woman offers to sell you a spare weapon. I only carry the best stuff! Molotovs. I'm gonna not get anything here, sadly. We don't have anybody who can steal or a dialogue option either. Off we go. Oh, I now know what that means up with the maple leaf in the top left corner, by the way. That's how many driving days to Canada. It's not dog, it's Sombra. Group finds a new person, Bernhard, not to be confused with Reinhardt. He's alone and wants to join. Bernhard claims to be experienced in medical matters. He twirls a scalpel around like an expert, but then drops it into a storm drain. Welcome aboard. Onward to Canada, let's check this guy out. We only know his morale is good. He keeps looking around nervously, and he's holding a rusty machete. Right, also while I'm in this screen, I might as well... I don't want the spatula, I don't want the knife. There we are. I am from Scotland, yes. Much like Dragonakis, who answered. Twitching down. That may explain the FPS loss earlier. Oh crap. It's only an hour long, but we have a siege to deal with. Shit. You are going to need a backup knife, almost certainly. My kung fu will see me through. Kung fu! Kung fu! It's only an hour, it's only an hour, it's only an hour. Also, I have a chair. I'm warning you. They fell over! Do extra damage to them! We've got to just keep the numbers down and we should be able to get out with ease. I do not want that. Teamwork, Hanzo, teamwork. I think we've only got 15 more in-game minutes, which is only like 20 seconds at tops. You want to actually do something, Bernard, or whatever the hell you were called? It's over, we can escape. That was actually a very easy siege. Although we got it so early on, I'm not surprised. This is some bullcrap! I want to believe that that's what Genji actually said when his brother tried to kill him. The group feels inspired. Genji plus one to all skills, yes. I'm taking that without even... caring about anyone else. I will be the zombie master. So everything went up. His medical was terrible. That's good to know. Morale is neutral. He shall be the superior Shimada. I can feel it. We're going to run into something and then switch to this. The group has a decent meal. Alright, that was an uneventful evening. 12 driving days until Canada. Anyone wants to do a sing-along? We should do a shut-up-along. While scavenging, the group runs into a man covered in cardboard boxes. He says he's been stuck there for days. He has a rifle lying on the ground outside of his reach. Should someone steal his weapon? Runs into a man covered in cardboard boxes. I think I just want to help him? What is Hanzo's reaction time? Wits is bad. Wits is neutral. Wits is unknown. Help him, recruit him, help him. Okay. The group saves the man from all the cardboard boxes, pinning him down. He can't spare a word, but is really grateful. Oh, Bernhard's loyalty is revealed as being terrible. He's a backstabber. And his morale went down because we helped someone. You are a zombie bait, is what you are. And there goes the car. While walking along the dirt road, Hansel thought they spotted a car, but it turned out to be a rock. That lowers morale. Group finds a nice spot to camp for a night. Wind and rain, they don't have a car to hide in, so their morale goes down again. At least eat a decent meal though, which kind of covers it. Oh, Bernhard, despite being a backstabbing prick, is actually... he's got a really good attitude. Bernhard rolls up his sleeves and starts tending to their wounds. Bernhard tries to help but lacks medical supplies. After hours of hiking, the group finds a car sitting alongside a country road. It's in great shape, but the keys are missing. A cabin is visible to the north. Well, we have no choice. We're hunting for those keys. And the zombies are irritable. Bernhard is Reinhardt's lost Emil brother? He's evil, Reinhardt. He is. Kung Fu. So it's a police car. Ooh. I want that fuel. Oh. It wasn't actually that much. Oh, there's a lot of stuff in here, though. Not good stuff, either. Well, some good stuff. No, Hansel, no. Don't get in too deep, you're getting tired. Look at that, he's doing bugger all, the Bernhard guy. Oh, there's the keys right there. I want to check the rest of the house first, though, because it seems like it's got a lot of stuff in it. I realize I think I missed some ammo back there. I'll get it on the way out. Everybody's inventory is pretty much full, apart from me using Kung Fu. If we're leaving anyway, I might as well take another machete, just to put it in storage. Also, it is a sword, so it fits. The key fits perfectly. Get in the car. Hello, Ray! Kill Bernhard 2K16. I'm going to be playing Deus Ex after we finish this run. So, pretty soon. Whoa, it's D.Va! It's nice to see a familiar face. She is kicking a car in frustration. The car is emitting plumes of smoke. Recruit D.Va to the team. The group accepts D.Va to the team. Her composure is revealed as terrible. Her strength is revealed as pretty bad. Onward to Canada. Well, now Bernhard is definitely expendable. The group finds a candy bar on the side of the road. It's fun-sized. Who gets to eat it? Whose morale is the worst? Genji's is pretty bad, Hansel's is neutral, you I don't care about, D.Va's is pretty bad, but we only just got her. It shall be going to Genji. Genji eats that candy big time. The sugary sweetness makes him feel a little bit better about his current life in not Canada. It actually raises his morale by 2 levels, so it's pretty good if you use it on one person. I never leave home without my trusty can opener. While driving on the death road, the group decides to make a stop. Hunting lodge, keep driving, or sporting goods store, and again, this probably means there's something really good there, but it's also really dangerous. Chat, do you want us to do the dangerous thing? Or keep going, or general stuff from the sporting goods store? Share? Oh, it's too late for share, we're on to something else. D.Va was found while rage quitting. It does sound like that. D.Va, the little gremlin. Do it. Hunting. Do danger, sporting goods, hunting, sporting goods, danger. Get Hanzo his bow. I don't think there's bows in the game, sadly. We could get him a rifle, though. Do the danger and kill Bind. Oh, that's actually a thing. I could go to the danger and only take... Hmm. I do actually see most people saying hunting, yeah, but go to hunting. The group spots a sign pointing the way to a nearby hunting lodge in the same direction. Some stragglers of a wandering horde are visible. Beware! Aggression mega cheesed! Although there isn't actually that many zombies, it's just that they're really pissed off. We might be able to handle them as a team. Huh. If we go as a team, however. What have you got on you? You've got a wrench. Take a knife. We're gonna store that. We're gonna store that. Store that. We're gonna go as a team because the horde is not very large. And I think we can maybe take them. Look how fast they're coming after us when they spot us though. Essentially the same map as before. I think there was a nightmare on the far left. Oh Christ. That's what we got in here. There's a giant bear. Aim for Beinhardt, whatever he's called. Oh, that we actually got Hansel a rifle. Hang on. I've got space, yeah. I'll give it to him when we're out of here alive. Does this do anything special? A huge stuffed bear looms in the cabin. Genji wrestles it for a few hours, or Genji searches the bear quickly. I want to wrestle you, no, hug you, whatever it is that Zarya says. Like big Siberian bear. I should have shut the door, yes, but we're about to head out anyway. I would assume searching the bear is probably smarter, or, you know, that makes time pass, which is a bad idea. The zombies ate cheese and now they're mad. Yeah, they are mega cheese, that's true. I think I'm just going to search the bear because I'm not Zarya, so I can't wrestle it. I'm also not a strong character. If we were playing as a strong character, I would wrestle it for sure. Wrestle, search, chat. I'm going against people who want to do wrestling because Genji does not have any strength. Oh, no, hang on, his strength is actually okay. It's Hanzo's is really bad. I'm doing search. Genji searches the stuffed bear on a hunch. Hey, there was a bunch of food and medical supplies hidden in a flap behind it. 5 medical supplies and an unknown amount. Oh, we got like 10 food there. Alright, it's time to leave. We need to get out. Kung Fu! Kung Fu! And I think I saw an item over here. No. Alright, let's just get out of here. We're taking a lot of chances. We got a lot of medical supplies, so we'll get back to full health, and we got a lot of food. Search. I did. I'm glad I actually went with the majority in the end. Not too bad. We are going to run out of fuel pretty quick for this car, though. I was planning on moving to Canada anyway. Everyone's back at full HP. The group finds an inn open for business. The owner wrings her hand. Give me 10 food. I'll watch over you while you sleep. She is super creepy. How many food do I have? 22 food. If you have someone with charisma, you can actually haggle her down to 5 food. Use the dragon. While I'm waiting for chat to decide for me what we're doing here. We want to give the rifle to Hansel. Although I don't want him to use it straight away. Yeah, there we are. Where did he find that pistol? Pistol will be going to D.Va. There we are. Drive off, pay 10 food, drive off, sleep. Buck her off. It's going to be a morale hit, but okay. The group peels off out of there pretty fast. They eat on the road, but never find a secure place to sleep. So unfortunately they're all tired, so hopefully we won't have any sieges to deal with, because otherwise we might be screwed. The world really isn't so bad, something. The group sees a city in the distance with zombies crowding the streets. Getting back alive may be difficult. Thick, but they're calm. We don't really need any guns, but the ammo might be helpful. We'll go to the police station. And we're already set up. Kung Fu! Well, that's a good start. I forgot to close the front door behind me again, but that's fine. That zombie up there is trapped. Maybe it's not fine. I don't know if I can close the front door. I don't think I can. There wasn't an option anyway. It's a big-headed zombie. What is D.Va doing right now? You okay there? You need a little Mountain Dew? Okay, she's going nuts. Calm the hell down! Grief. Bye, Darkfly. Junkrat and Roadhog, we're going to have to do that at some point. It'll help me learn their names as well, so I don't keep on saying the wrong one when we're playing Overwatch. Because there's some wires crossed somewhere that makes me do that a lot. That zombie came in and immediately fell over. Let's see it here. Oh, no, can't pick that up. I can't open it, rather, you pick it up only. Nope. Is there any other building we can get into up here? Nope, maybe down below. Does D.Va have the Berserk trait? Nope, Fierce Temper. She is pissed off about something, probably the lack of Doritos. Or gaming systems, or electricity. There doesn't appear to be any other houses I can get in, so I think we're just gonna go, unfortunately. But hey, at least we got out alive. We're gonna lose our car soon, though. In fact, we're gonna lose it as soon as it needs more petrol. Oh, there we go. Yeah. Shit. While walking along the side... Hang on. While walking along side... Alright, I see. Side a large stream, Genji notices some fish in the water. Genji tries their luck, goes into the water and tries to catch some fish by hand. By some miracle, Genji is able to catch a decent-sized catfish. Everybody's morale increased and we've got 6 food. The group is robbed by weak bandits. The bandits are of a kind that would normally not be a problem if they had a car. Have Hanzo shout, "What did you say?" Hanzo says something like, "What did you say?" But really, he just didn't hear them. The bandits misunderstand this and are very intimidated by Hanzo. They flee and scatter. Hanzo has no idea what happened, but is glad the bandits are gone. They can't be stopped, apparently. Alright, wandering through a town, D.Va discovers a new hybrid car. I think we just get this for free, right? Yeah, we do. Alright, that's handy. The group meets a woman limping around with a crutch. One of her legs was wounded in a recent fall as she was getting away from zombies. I'm gonna make Bernhard do the right thing, because he's a dick. Bernhard tries to treat the woman's busted leg. He takes a day to help the woman treat her leg. She is thankful, but can't spare much. Gives me some food. We lose more food from having to eat a decent meal, though. The group finds a cabinet. What's with all the cabins we're finding today? No zombies in sight. It has a wood stove in it, but no wood. Go ahead and chop wood. Who should go and chop wood? Bernhard. Bernhard chops a bunch of wood and gets the wood stove going before passing out from exhaustion. He is very tired. His strength is revealed as bad, but it goes up and increases everybody else's morale to fantastic. Good. Hanzo sneezes and everyone runs in fear of dragons. It's grinning out. The car is running fine, but an error code shows up on the dashboard. The group has no idea what's wrong, so they pull over to see what's up. Bernhard carefully inspects it. Genji punches it real hard, or Genji kicks it a lot. What is Bernhard's mechanical skill? Because that makes it sound like he knows what he's doing. Strength is super bad, his attitude is great. We don't know his mechanical skill. We do know that Genji's strength is pretty good though, so kicking it or punching it might actually have a positive result. I mean, if we go by the short, Genji prefers kicking to punching. Kill Bernhard? Bernhard? I will certainly try. Punch it. Genji kick, let him inspect, kick it. Alright, kick it seems to be the majority. Genji steps outside of the car and just wails on it with his feet. What a workout! There, our light stays on though. Alright, I don't think we got anything out of that. But there was no detriment either. The group feels a sense of dread. Something dangerous is coming. The road ahead seems like they're getting steadily more crowded with undead and they're getting riled up. Is it a trading camp? Oh, it's a trading camp inside a Yalmart. Medical supplies, katana lady, Molotov man. Anything I can liberate for free? Group meets a man who's carrying many swords. They clank around as he moves. One day I'll make the finest zombie slicing sword ever seen. I just have to figure out how to make swords first. I'll sell you some. I'm doing this only because I'm playing as Genji. The group finds a katana of the type you'd get at the mall. It looks like it might break at any moment. What a ripoff. Sounds about right. Do I have it? Who actually got it? Oh, I guess we won't get it until we leave. Man selling medical supplies, we don't have enough. Buy my bombs! We found the in-game junk rat. Buy 2 pipe bombs for 5 food. No, back away slowly. That was a bit of a wash, unfortunately. I like Tyrant's idea. Genji out on the engine. Now, hang on, let me just see here. There it is. Okay, we're sorted. While driving on the death road, the group decides to make a stop. We're not going to Riverside Rescue because we have a full party anyway. Bullet-ridden house or drive more. We'll go to the bullet-ridden house. The group sees a house in the distance. Getting closer, it looks like a large gunfight happened there. Alright. Shouldn't be too bad. Since I have Kung Fu to fall back on, I'll take the katana. Diva, you're probably good with what you've got. You can have that. Alright, let's go. Attack your katana! Ryujin no Kenwo Karai! I'm gonna kill you! And the katana's gonna break after like a swing! A lot of rifle. Oh, I did give Hanzo the rifle. Good, good, good. So we just found ammo for it. I wish my ult lasted this long in the game. Hey look, we've got a Spamzo in our team now too. Okay, a perfectly good shotgun that someone will hopefully... Oh look, the Diva's going nuts again every time she's trying to pick something up. Why is that happening? What have you got? You have a full inventory, that's why you're not picking it up. I have room to pick it up. I should do it. Ooh, medicine. Good. This way, team. Been down there. There is something to grab in here. Two things, in fact. Remember rightly, someone said that the katana is actually good damage-wise. It just has a really, really high break chance, like 5% every time you swing or something. Maybe even like 15. Although I think if it was 15, it would have broken by now. My me gents just, you know, taking some food, taking some ammo. Taking some chairs, very, very important that part. There's a grenade in here. I definitely don't want anyone else grabbing that. I will take the grenade. I will take the grenades. Because they can't be trusted, quite frankly. Did I already go in here? I did not. This actually proved like a really, really good scavenge. My food is pretty good. All the ammo we've found, although Hanzo, I just picked up the bed. My strength stat must be higher than what I'm used to. I didn't know you could even pick up beds. Again with the chairs. Hey, they're a viable tactic in this game. Let's get out of here. Yeah, that was a really good scavenge. 11 food, 43 gas. 5 medicine, which is the important part. Exhausted after an extra long drive, the group scouts out a camping spot and falls asleep immediately after. Eat a decent meal. Ooh, food is actually our worst bit. I didn't realise we were using 8 per time. I know what I'm doing, I've played a lot of zombie video games, says D.Va. I believe her. The group tries to loot a grocery store, but it has been picked absolutely clean. Genji finds a magazine rack. He decides to grab one to read. American Guns, Turnkey and Good to Go, Cat Picture Videos, or Giant Farts Monthly. So we did Giant Farts Monthly last time, so we're not doing that. I'm pretty sure we've done cat video pictures already and it's a morale boost. And I think our morale is actually okay now. Great, great, good, and okay. So yeah, we don't need the cat videos. Guns aren't my style. We're going to do Turnkey Good to Go. This was the car magazine before society exploded. The insightful articles have a calming effect on Genji. Composure increased and mechanical increased. Okay, we don't know what the mechanical skill is though. Where are the exploding zombies and the tongue ones? Asks D.Va, because she's horny. The group continues making progress along the death road. Alright, trader camp. Ooh, it might be a trader camp where we can steal stuff. Hello, friend. Runs into someone selling extra rifle ammo. Well, we're not trading away any of our food because we need it. I'm basically just here for free stuff. Turnkey, I'm glad that the chat actually agreed with what I decided before. What is this? The group finds a dumpster. It's locked tight with a slot in the side. There are weapon names and prices scrawled near the hole. Just drop food in here, says a tiny voice in the dumpster. You have 3 food left. This isn't enough food for the dumpster person. My character from Dead by Daylight is in here. This is his backstory. This is all just his elaborate backstory. This Death Road to Canada is actually just a prequel to Dead by Daylight. What is this? He's got a minigun. The group finds a man selling a bunch of firearms. He's holding a minigun that has both a scope and a laser sight and a flashlight attached to it. However, his selection seems like pretty common stuff. I would love to try and rob him, but we don't have soul food with us. I read Turkey and was so confused. I actually, like, before I read it out loud, I had to parse it a couple of times. I don't like how long that took to start. Every day gets me a little closer to Canada. How close are we, anyway? Mall of the Dead. The group is driving through a ruined city when... Oh, shit. Alright, 1.5 hour late game siege. This is not going to go well. Let's go. It begins! Oh crap, it's the same one that always ruins me. It's the one with the cops. And there goes the attack of Katana. Is it the one with the cops? I thought I heard them firing. Oh yeah. I really should save the grenades for when I'm trying to escape. There's the diabetes man over there. Yeah, this is what I trained for! Kung fu their ass off! Also, stay away from the door, because we want the zombies to fall down where the door is not. Ready to rock. Sorry, chat, I can't look right now, because this is always a pain in the arse when you get it. I've got to concentrate. Shit. Other side, other side, other side. I think most of the zombies are actually cut off, so we've kind of lucked out with the layout it's given us by having this the grating down. It'd be much more manageable if the zombies didn't stop falling through the goddamn ceiling. Or rather, if they did stop. I should have saved my ult for this. Ah! Come on, it's almost 1 hour 50, it must be. We're good, we're good. Clearly the newest one is hard, that's why it gives you the 2 cops, but even then, get it. Did I get out without anyone dying? Yeah, I did! 149 zombies destroyed. This car should have no problems getting to Canada, he says as it starts smoking. The group feels inspired having survived the situation. Hansel faster run speed. It fits him to a T, I have to. Hansel gets really good at running. Hansel now permanently runs faster. Hansel's dexterity increases. So that, I think that means it carries over even if he turns up randomly in another game. So that's long term we just invested in. It is just smooth sailing from now on. Bernhard, are you on drugs? The group camps in a sturdy building. It seems to be an old repair shop. The group didn't have nearly enough food to eat. Doubt festers. So morale's going to start dropping now because we've run out of food. Just go to sleep. But on the plus side, our morale is so high, it's going to take a while before it starts really affecting us. There goes the car, though. Once on our X12 says, "Hey, I finally got a Twitter. Good. Is that you who followed me? I saw I got a Twitter message while I was playing. Nope, somebody liking a video." While walking, Hanzo doesn't pay attention, and we lose stuff from his bag. Damn it. While walking, Diva stubs her toe badly. It's not a big deal, but it's really annoying. We still have enough medicine to heal her, though, hopefully before we lose it. And we just got a free car. Diva is really good at finding free cars. 91 gas as well. The group finds an isolated car garage. The sign says, "Master Tuners." We get a bunch of gas. Repair and tune up, why not? Genji tries to repair the car and hopes it goes a little further. It's revealed it's not being very good at mechanical skill. The group finds that there is no food left at all. Despair creeps in. Damn it. Hang on a minute, their morale dropped down to super bad, like, really, really quickly because of the no food. That's a problem. Diva's incredible powers of positive thinking kicks in, shielding her from the horrors of reality. Well, things could be worse, I guess. So she just got a random morale increase, and she got stronger as well. Diva's spirit starts to crack. She might not be so lucky next time. Ah. So if she has to get this again, something real bad is going to happen. Okay. Whoa, it's Flick. It's nice to see a familiar face. He was sleeping in an abandoned house. He is slightly irritated to have been woken up. I'm not going to recruit myself because I want Bernhard to die. I could have just dumped him there, but that's not as fun. Hanzo's incredible powers of positive thinking kick in, shielding him from the horrors of reality. I guess he has the same trait Diva does. While driving on the death road, the group decides to stop for supplies. Rest up with car. Yeah. Zombie forecast thick and irritated. Alright. Oh, so there's another car here. I don't know what type of car that is, actually. Let's see what he says. Car looks like it's in really good condition, but where are the keys? Alright. What I'm really interested in is food, and I see food back there. Good start. We need what? 8 every time we need food? Ugh. That's the bad side of having a full team. Also, if we could find a mech for Diva, that'd be very nice. Toilet gas, I suppose we'll go for it. Oh, or a toilet bullet. Somebody's been eating ammunition. Oh yes, this is the room we wanted. It's full of zombies, but we can do this. Alright, there's the keys. I guess we'll take the new car, because it might be better. Someone want to take that pistol? Oh, Diva's freaking out again. She goes nuts every time she's trying to pick something up. I will take the gun. It means I can't use Kung Fu until we're out of here, but whatever. There shouldn't be that many zombies in our way. Let's go, team. Ooh, it's fast. It's not a bullet, it's a suppository. Ew. How close to Canada are we? 8 driving days until Canada. Campground that the group sets up smells terrible. Drive off with no sleep. We need the morale, unfortunately. So morale increases. But we're tired. Please no CGs. While driving on the death road, the group decides to make a stop for supplies. Apartment, gas station rescue, or more. Well, I want more choices. Busy hotel, passing-by, or mall rescue. Busy hotel. Dropping frames again? Oh, damn, we are, yeah. That must be a Twitch thing. I don't think there's anything on my end. Give it a second and it should clear up. Let me just make sure Steam isn't trying to update something, or maybe I left the Baldonet on. No, I did not. Apartment would have had food. Well, bugger. Bear with it here, I'm not going to go in until the frames stop dropping. Alright, seems fine. Yeah. So D.Va is out of pistol ammo, annoyingly. This is the most items I've ever had, I think. Wait, I've got a pistol with ammo? No, give that to D.Va. ...69 bullets, 32 rifle shots, 17 shotgun shells... ...and I've got kung fu and 2 grenades. What else do you need? Kill them all! Nope, back this way. Gotta be something worth getting here. Another pistol, some pistol ammo. I just exploded that zombie with my fist. More bullets, more bullets, more bullets! What was that noise? Why did it make a noise like an elevator? Weird. Is no one taking a gun? Oh, I have space for it. Alright, actually D.Va freaked out a little bit and she took it. I'm not sure I trust her with a gun, but, you know. And there's one more gas. Bernard, get out of the way. So far, we've not really found much of anything. Maybe the other half of those? We still haven't checked up the way either. Oh, food. Food. Kung Fu! Oh, this is the room we want. Lots more rifle ammo for Hanzo. Nothing in there for us. Careful now. Hang on, we've lost a Dorito Goblin. D.Va! Oh, there you are. Don't scare me like that. If anyone's gonna die here, it's Bernhard. Oh, there's a dresser in here. Damn it. She's just firing indiscriminately now. Now, we found 4 food in total. That's not terrible. Let's go. Still not enough to make a good meal though, unfortunately. Is Twitch dropping more frames? There's a dog wandering nearby, it's keeping its distance but watching the group with guarded interest. It becomes... Alright, so if you have 5 food left, feed the dog 2 cans of food, leave the dog alone. We have no room for it anyway. Oh damn, it is dropping more frames. The group meets a man trying to repair his broken car. He clearly has no idea what he's doing. Back to being fine again. Seems like it. Sure, Genji will help. Genji tries to fix the man's broken car. He tries over and over. He can't do it. Damn it. His loyalty is revealed as being neutral. Didn't expect that to bring everybody's morale down. The group is sitting around a campfire. Finding this campsite was rough, so they're getting in a bad mood. Oh, shit. We've got to sing a song to try and bring morale up or people are going to start just abandoning. Goop tries to keep spirits high by singing. Whether or not the singing was any good mostly depends on your attitude. So Genji's morale increased. Oh no, his attitude was viewed as generally being pretty good. Thanks a lot, Zombie Obama! Genji decides to blow off some steam by delivering a seemingly endless rant to everyone. Try to ignore it or tell Genji to shut up. His morale is already terrible. Tell Genji to shut up. Everyone tells Genji to shut it. He doesn't take this well and leaves the group in a huff. Oh, bugger. Okay. Let's try and get an apartment for food. Grocery store, that'll do. Sadly, we've lost our Kung Fu master. It was going so well. I knew morale was going to screw us up as well. Diva, you have 3 pistols. You okay? You only need 1. There you go. Ah, that's unfortunate. Genji was doing so well. The Kung Fu skill is just... It's a little bit OP, it seems like. Wow. And Hanzo is garbage. He gets tired after 3 swings. But he is good with a rifle. He's also good at attracting attention. Oh, now that Genji's just randomly walked away from bad... Oh, Christ. Bad morale. I've tilted. I lost his bloody grenades as well. I want in that room because that's the food room. Look at Bernard doing absolutely fuck all up there. There we go. Spatula, I don't want it. Actually, do I have an inventory space? No, I don't, but Diva does. Meh. What is with having 2 bathrooms and they're both the same size as the damn store? Shop smart, shop S smart. I get that reference. Oh, I missed my Kung Fu Genji. Come on! Come on! What the hell? I've never seen the number get this high! Are you kidding? Start! Chat, is this a glitch? Or is the car just... There we go. Christ! Well, the car's almost wrecked now. Oh, it's CR! It's nice to see a familiar face. He was found trying to pull open a door that said push on it. Mysterious past friend of dog. I guess we'll recruit him as another body. Alright, let's go. CR hopes to drive to Canada in a fancy car. He's holding a frying pan, he's friend of dog. And that's about it. Okay. Five bandits ambush the group while they are about to sneak into the zombie infested house. The bandits speak in a half whisper, afraid to attract undead attention. They say to hand them over some supplies or they'll yell. CR tells the bandits to cool it. In a faint whisper, CR tells the bandits to kill it. The bandits are, for what feels like a long time, taken aback by this. The bandits were all talk and don't make a sound when their bluff is called. The group goes back to the car as the bandits creep away. That's the power of cool it. I forgot CR also had the cool it power. Ah, there goes the car. The group runs into a particularly rough stretch of road. Yeah, Diva got hurt. Oh, everybody got hurt! Damn it. I'm going to lose this one due to bad morale and running out of fuel. Refuse and fight. Everybody got hurt, but at least we kept our supplies. The group finds a long road filled of abandoned cars. Alright, here's our chance to get back to another car. We're just going to have to go head first in and hope that we live. Balls to the wall! Please, if someone dies, make it be Bernhard. Follow the path I'm making through the zombies, people. Don't get caught up. If you get caught up, you die. Oh god, they're getting caught. Oh god, no. Well, CR's still living. I don't know about the other two. I haven't played the noise of someone dying. Oh, it's a family station wagon. Get in! We're in! Give it all I've got! I'm giving it all I got! We lived! We don't have enough medical supplies to heal anybody, though. Hang on, how close are we? We must be getting close now, right? This has actually been going a while. 6 driving days from Canada. Bernhardt runs low on medical supplies. The group notices a geometrically impossible vortex forming in front of the moving car. It hovers a few feet in front of them at bumper speed, humming ominously. Drive through it, Bernhardt, calculate its vectors, Hanzo, fight it or don't mess with it. I know what happens if you calculate its vectors with an actual smart character. I don't know if you do it with a dumb character. Is Bernhardt smart or is Bernhardt dumb? We don't know what his wits is, so he could be either. What do you think, chat? Calculate his vectors or fight it? Drive through it? No, Hanzo didn't die. Genji technically didn't die either. He just left because he was unhappy. Drive through it. Alright, we'll drive through it. Sierra puts the pedal to the metal and drives on through. The car gets through but takes some damage. The group emerges back on the road a moment later like nothing happened, yet they feel different. It turned them all female. So, although Hanzo looks the same, Sierra is definitely a woman. Oh, I reversed all their names as well. D.Va looks like she's some kind of Widowmaker fangirl now. Alright, we're all ladies now, and our names have been reversed. And there goes the car again. This run is ending very shortly. Oh, we're getting hurt. Abandoned Lodge, yep. Storm moved in. Well, at least the morale increased. But then it went right back down. Don't have the medical supplies. While walking along the road, oh, hands will find a free car. That's not that bad. We still have no food and no medical supplies, though. Leave the camp. I can't take the morale hit for shooting the antique cans. Oh hey, D.Va lacks enough medical supplies but manages to improvise, so she just healed a little bit. Bernhardt sneaks off when everyone is busy. She is a true weasel who steals the keys for the car, intending to take everything for herself. She drives off with most of the supplies. 14 weapons lost, all my gas, and most of my ammo. Bernhardt screwed us at the end. A bee keeps harassing the group, it takes forever to leave. If only he had a car. That son of a bitch. When weather suddenly turns bad, the group is caught in the open and must keep moving. This is how we die. The group is ambushed while crossing. They want all our gas and half of our ammo and medical supplies. We actually have nothing, so take nothing. Yeah, we didn't have anything worth taking. I know I should have got him killed earlier, I know. Alright, trying to get a car, let's just do it. Push through, team. That traitor took our car. I hope he died. If I run into him in another game, I'm getting him killed for sure, so remind me, chat. Oh, Christ. I'm down here. Oh. Oh. Get through. Get through. This way. What else do I have here? Crowbar. Oh, there's the car. Go! Flirt! Bernhardt is an ass. Yep. Well, at the plus side, when this ends, we're going to be like the closest I've ever got to Canada. We're 5 days away. Hey, CR got a little bit healed by D.Va. She's managing to heal people without medical supplies. I guess we'll visit the trader camp, get their stuff for free. You're a dodo from Ark. The group meets a strange and menacing figure. He or she is wearing a mask. Oh, I see. It's probably like a reference to Miami Connection. Miami Connection. It's a movie. Hang on, why did you say something in red there? What did you say? Hotline Miami, that's what I was thinking of. I don't think there's anything I can do here. Oh wait, D.Va has charm. Hang on. What are you offering? Shotgun shells? Nah. D.Va accidentally just comes off as creepy, the group is asked to leave. Well, shit. Although apparently I'm still here. Oh shit! D.Va takes a big box of shotgun shells and walks away with it. In a calm and fluid motion, the shell merchant whips out a shotgun and starts blasting. D.Va is killed. Welp. I have a feeling that going to Canada is a waste of time. Yep, see, this is where we die. We did get a hockey stick from somewhere. Alright, let's face our deaths together. Me and CR, because D.Va's gone. Shot to death by a merchant. Oh, come on, the coming out of the ground is terrible. We just have to fight them off from this very corner for about another hour. Which is not gonna happen. CR's dead. Then goes Handel. Well, not quite yet, because they're actually too busy eating him. I'm just gonna stand here while they're eating him? I did say the Reaper made a good corpse. Oh no, they turned on me. There we go. Ah, that was a long one. You have died on the death road to Canada. Dang it.